In this lecture, we will talk about the basics of for loop and while loop. So let's get started. Before diving into the basics of for loop and while loop, let's first try to understand the importance of loops. Why loops are required. Suppose I'm a boss of a multinational company who wants to send this notice to all the employees that our office will be closed on Sunday, September 5. So enjoy your holiday. Now, in my office, there are 1,000 employees. And if I want to send this notice to all the employees, then this will be a very tedious task if I send it manually. Instead, if I write a program like this, which will automatically send this notice to all the 1,000 employees, then this would be better than sending this particular notice manually. Even though if we want to send this notice through Gmail, then also we have to do a lot of work. But if we write a program that will automatically send this particular notice to all the 1,000 employees, then that would be much better. We can do this with the help of loops. Here I'm writing a while loop which will send this particular notice to all the 1,000 employees very easily. Of course, we need to replace this line send the above notice with the actual code which will actually send this notice to all the employees in their respective IDs. But here we don't need to bother about this. We just need to understand why loops are so important to us. It's not very difficult to understand the importance of loops. Loops are quite valuable. Because we the human beings are not very good in repeating the same task again and again, but computers are good at it. And we know we need to repeat the same thing many number of times. Therefore, loops are very much required. Now let's try to understand what is while loop, what is the syntax of while loop, and how it actually works. Here is the syntax of while loop, that is while, an expression, and the set of statements written immediately after the while loop. Now, if the expression results in true value, then definitely the statements will get evaluated. And after that, it will again check the condition. And if the expression still returns true, then again, these statements will get executed. It will continue to get executed until and unless the expression returns false. Okay. Now, let's consider one example in order to understand how while loop really works. Here I have declared a variable I and I have assigned it a value 3. After that, inside this while loop, I am checking the condition is I is greater than 0 or not. Here, as we know, I is 3, right? As 3 greater than 0 is true, right? Therefore, we will go inside this while loop and print the value 3 on the console window, right? After that, we decrement the value of I, so the value of I now becomes 2, right? And after decrementing the value of I, we again check the condition. That is I is greater than 0 or not? Right now, the value of I is 2. Therefore, I is replaced with 2. Is 2 greater than 0? Yes, true. After the condition is satisfied, now we go inside and simply print the value 2 on the console window, right? After printing the value 2, it simply decrements the value, which makes it 1. Now, we again check the condition. Is 1 greater than 0 or not? As 1 is greater than 0, which is true, therefore we simply print the value 1 onto the console window. After printing the value 1, we again decrement the value of I, which makes I 0. Now, again we check the condition. Is 0 greater than 0 or not? 0 is not greater than 0. Right? That means it results in false value. If the condition returns false, then we get outside of this loop. So the final output is 3, 2, and 1. Okay? Now let's try to understand how for loop works. First of all, let's consider the syntax of for loop. Here inside the parenthesis, we have initialization step, condition step, and then increment decrement step. After that, we have some set of statements. Now let's see one example. This is an example of a while loop. Here I have declared a variable and assigned it a value 3. After assigning the value 3, I check the condition. That is I greater than 0 or not? After that, we simply print the value of I and decrement the value of I. We can rewrite this whole program like this. For I equals to 3, I greater than 0, I minus minus, print I. They both are one and the same. There is no difference between this program and this program. If you really want to understand how for loop works, you first have to understand how while loop works. This is the prerequisite. Now, as we can clearly see, the first step in while loop is initialization step. Here also, the first step is initialization. I is initialized with the value 3. After initialization, the condition is checked. That is I greater than 0 or not? If this condition is satisfied, then the next step is printing the value of I. Here also, after condition checking, the value of I is printed. Please remember, here after checking the condition, we are not decrementing the value of I. After checking the condition, if the condition is satisfied, then we are going to print this value of I, as in the case of while loop. After printing the value of I, we simply decrement the value of I. Here also, we did the same. After printing the value of I, we decrement the value of I. And after decrementing the value of I, we again check the condition. Is condition really satisfied or not? Here also, after decrementing the value of I, we check the condition. Is I greater than 0 or not? If again I is greater than 0, then we again print the value of I. And again we do the decrement and again check the condition and so on. So as you can clearly see, both for loop and while loop are one and the same. But the difference lies in number of lines of code. Here you are just writing 4 lines of code. And here you are having 7 lines of code. It is your personal choice which loop you want to choose for your program. Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this lecture.